everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Today is day 3 of Scraptember, and today's prompt is a sketch. And so I am using this 2-page sketch by Allison Davis for Scrapbook Generations. And this was originally posted, I think, back in 2014 in the Create Digital magazine. And I have posted that at the beginning of the video. And I am working on some pictures that we had taken back in January when we were in Hawaii. And when we were there, it was kind of a cool thing. The waves were so big that they were able to have a surfing competition that they had not held in 7 years. So the swells were going up 20, 30, 40 feet. It was just an amazing thing to see. And so, although we didn't actually go to the surfing competition because it was kind of insane, we did get to watch a lot of people out there surfing. We got to see the waves and just really enjoyed our time there. And so I really wanted to document that historic event. It was a really cool thing to watch. And so I have some older stash. I have some papers from Basic Gray Obscure line, and I thought it was perfect because it has these surfers on there. And so I'm going to add that to the right page, very similar to the elements that Allison had. I think she has kind of a big wave or swirl, and I am going to add some water features as well to this side that I have cut out from my Cricut Design Space. Now, the other page that I'm using is from Echo Park. It worked out really well. I don't know if you can see it too well, but it has these little tiny circles, and this is the B side of this paper. But in the Obscure collection, either I've used them all or something, but I just couldn't find a really good partner page. So I decided to use this, and then I'm going to use some of the other papers from the Obscure line to accent that left side to kind of bring it all together. So here is my wave, and I'm going to go ahead and mark this off because I really don't want to cover up that surfboard, which I think actually would have been fine in hindsight, but I wanted it to kind of look as if the surfboard was riding the wave. So I'm just going to go ahead and put that on there. And the paper that I used has a little bit of a sheen to it. I don't know if you could see it there, but I think it works out really well. And I'm going to continue to embellish this particular wave to just give it a little bit more realistic feel, give it that white cap look. And that's one of the things that I really, really loved about this paper. It just has such motion to it, I feel like. So I really love that. And back in the day, I was one of those people who was absolutely obsessed with Basic Gray. And so I have quite a bit of it in my stash. And I'm a little bit sad to use it because I have hoarded it for so long, but I'm very happy to give it a good prominent place in my scrapbooks as well. So so I am going to be okay with it. So I do kind of vary from the original sketch this way. There are 3 small pictures on the original sketch, and I had 4. I wanted to really use all of those surfing pictures that I had taken. And of course, they were really far out in the water, so I didn't get a whole lot of real close pictures. But I did get quite a few. And just looking at those waves, I mean, you can see how much white there is to the waves, and that's just crazy. Now, on the left side, just to give you a little bit of history as I'm putting down my journaling, when we were at the pipeline, which is where most people do the surfing, there was a surfboard that I took a picture of, and there was this really fun sign. It was funny to me, and so I thought I would use that as well as some of the surfing pictures, just to kind of give the mood of it. Everyone who was surfing, everyone was super polite and made space for everyone. And it was just a really cool thing to do. Being from the Midwest, we don't see too many surfing contests. Now, occasionally, when we're up on Lake Michigan, we can see some people boogie boarding, or maybe I think there's some other kite boarding or something like that. But never anything like this. Our waves never get this big. And it was really cool. And we absolutely loved the North Shore when we were on Oahu, and spent a lot of time up there. So I'm sure that you will see a lot of photos from the North Shore, because that's where most of the beaches were. And my favorite Turtle Beach is up there, and I just was absolutely obsessed with that beach. So now what I'm doing is I'm going to go ahead and put some of these photos, the left side, onto some white cardstock. I wanted to just give a little bit of a border there and a place for it to land, a place for my title. I think it's similar on the original sketch, and so that is what I'm doing here. So I'm just going to cut that out. I decided I wanted to give an inch and a half down at the bottom, just to add my title. Yeah, and that kind of brings that white over to the left side as well. There's actually quite a lot of white on the right side, and so I wanted to at least have a little bit on the left. Now, here is the hoarder in me. Originally, I thought, oh, I'm just going to back it with this other piece of obscure paper. And then I'm like, you know what? I don't have to use all of that paper. I can just cut strips of it, and that will be okay. I don't know if I'm ever going to need to use this other side, but I told you I'm obsessed with basic gray, and so I thought, you know what? I'm just going to do some strips of it, and then I have the rest of the paper, and I don't have to totally say goodbye to it. So there you go. I have a unhealthy relationship with paper, but it's okay. It's okay. But I really liked kind of that yellowy green color. It pulls in the colors from the right side, without being completely overbearing. When I was kind of picking out my papers, I thought, well, maybe I'll just do yellow on that side. I'll kind of carry that over. But it didn't really work with my pictures. There is a little bit yellow in that sign, so it was nice to get that yellow on there, but it just was a little too overpowering. I really did want to keep with the water and the blue. One thing I will do off camera, I decided I wanted to go ahead and put another strip of paper at the top and bottom edge, and I will do that off camera because it was sort of an afterthought. But what I'm doing here is something you see me do a lot. I have this really thin washi tape, and I absolutely love it. And I love when I'm doing strips like this, I like to put that little thin line. It kind of looks like some stitching, which this is an Allison Davis design, so she's really into stitching. I just don't have the time and patience to do stitching on all of my pages, so that does something really quickly. And now I'm just gonna put out my title. I'm gonna do the actual title. I'm gonna glue it all down off camera, but I just wanted to get a kind of an idea of how I wanted it, and I'm just gonna do Surfing the Pipeline. And I think I said I used these letter stickers in one of my other recent videos, and I think maybe it's from Doodlebug, but I'm not sure. The top of it is cut off. I don't know why the top of it is cut off, but I really like them. I love the font of this. And sometimes when I find some stickers or thickers or whatever and really like the font, I use them so much for a while. So you may be seeing a little bit more of this line again later. So, I'm kind of deciding where I want those letters to go, just shuffling them around a little bit. But then I decide, you know what, I will mess with that later. I will, I'm just going to shuffle them around and make sure that it's sort of centered. So, there you go. There's my sort of title that will be glued on at the end of the video. So, now I am looking for some stickles. I really wanted to do some white capping on my, on my waves. And I have to tell you, I don't use a lot of stickles anymore. I have a ton of them. I am slowly getting through my stash. But I love how this dried. And you can see me kind of struggling there a little bit. I was running out, and I was very glad that I had a second bottle of this, or I would have been very sad. Probably a good thing to check before you start painting on your layout. But I did run out, so I'm going to grab that second bottle of stickles and get those white caps done. I have to be honest, I stuck my hand in these so much. I even laid my phone on my layout. So beware. Stickles are wet. They take a while to dry. And so beware when you're using them that it does take a little while. Maybe that's just me. I thought they would be dried hours later. I was wrong. but the good news is, if you do sit your phone on it, they do dry and it comes right off. So that's a good tip there if you ever run into that. I think I had gotten a little bit spoiled by Nuvo drops because they seem to dry so quickly. And maybe it's because I put this on so thick because I really, really wanted it to look like white caps, that it took a minute for it to dry. So now, along with those stickles, I'm going to add on some sequins from Spiegel Mom Scraps. I really love this. It kind of has all of those colors that I have used in my layout, and I just think it's going to work so well to add just a little bit more sparkle. I wanted to use a lot more, but I decided I wanted to just kind of keep those sparkles up on the right side. Now, in hindsight, maybe I should have put some on the left side to kind of bring that through. But I didn't, and I think that's okay. That's fine. If I wanted to do it later, I could, but I really just wanted to bring in that wave there. And so once I have those on there, that is going to be kind of the gist of my layout. I hope that you enjoyed this video today. If you did, I would love it if you'd hit that thumbs up button. And if you are not yet a subscriber to my channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and you'll see a lot more content of what I have coming up. That notification bell always lets you know when I have a new video up. And of course, it is Scraptember. So we're hoping to get one up every day of the month. Fingers crossed as I am leaving on vacation fairly soon. So let's see if I can get these all done. So anyway, I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.